Wegovy and Zepbound are both FDA-approved weight loss medications that belong to a drug class called GLP-1 agonists, which were originally designed to treat type 2 diabetes. Even though these meds come from the same drug family, they have their differences that are unique, and they're worth knowing, especially if you're considering starting one of these agents. My name is Dominique, and I'm a clinical pharmacist, and I'm here to teach you how these agents work and break down what makes these weight loss options different so you can make better informed decisions regarding your healthcare as well as your pocket. Wegovy contains the same ingredient as Ozempic, which is semaglutide. That's right, same ingredient. And naturally, your next question would be, what makes Wegovy different than Ozempic? And the short answer is branding, marketing, big pharma making that coin. Ozempic carries the FDA indication for type 2 diabetes, and after they saw substantial weight loss as a side effect of the medication, Ozempic started becoming over and inappropriately prescribed for weight loss. Now, this presented an opportunity for manufacturers to make some money. Alas, Ozempic was rebranded to Wegovy, which shortly was approved by the FDA to be used for weight loss alone, with or without diabetes. They have the same ingredient and their doses differ less than 0.5 milligrams from each other, but yet they have different brand names. Same thing goes for Zepbound. Zepbound contains the same active ingredient in Mounjaro, which is tirzepatide. They have the same ingredient and their doses are actually the same, but yet they have different brand names. Essentially, what I'm saying is Wegovy is the weight loss branded version of Ozempic and Zepbound is the weight loss branded version of Mounjaro. Now, let's get into how Wegovy and Zepbound are similar and different. Both Zepbound and Wegovy are once weekly injections and have substantial weight loss effects. But then there are some areas that they differ. Well, actually a lot of ways, like how they work, how much they cost, available formulations, heart benefit, and one is a bit more effective or a lot more effective at weight loss than the other. Don't worry, I'm not going to leave you hanging. I'm actually going to walk you through each of these. Both of these drugs belong to GLP agonist drug class. GLP-1, glucagon-like peptide 1, is a hormone released from the intestines when food is ingested. And once GLP-1 is released, it is able to bind to specific receptors found in various tissues throughout the body, including our gastric cells, cells in the pancreas, which is the organ that releases insulin, and the hypothalamus, which is the area of the brain that regulates hunger and satiety, so that feeling of fullness. When GLP-1 binds to these receptors, it, number one, helps the pancreas produce more insulin on its own. Number two, works to prevent the liver from releasing additional blood sugar that's already stored in the body. And number three, it's slowing down the rate of food leaving your stomach, which we call delayed gastric emptying, which means more time to break down carbohydrates, so we're getting less spikes of blood sugar following our meals. So not only does this reduce the sugar spikes, but it also is making you feel fuller faster, so you're not eating as much per meal. And here's where weight loss also comes in, which is the fourth benefit. GLP-1 also has activity in the brain that suppresses the appetite, meaning you're eating less and you're feeling fuller faster. In fact, this appetite suppression can be so significant, I've seen patients tell me that they can barely get one meal in a day. Both Wegovy and Zepbound have GLP-1 agonist effect, but Zepbound has an additional hormone called GIP. GIP stands for gastric inhibitory peptide in other translations, but it's another hormone that has similar effects of GLP-1 and how it facilitates insulin production. But one of the things that makes it different is that it actually stimulates the release of stored blood sugar in the event that someone's blood sugar drops too low. Essentially, the addition of GIP to GLP-1 in Zepbound enhances the weight loss effect, but provides a buffer to prevent blood sugar from falling too low. If you're a data nerd like me, I included the data, so let's talk about it. In the clinical trials, both Zepbound and Wegovy were tested in adult patients without diabetes who were classified as obese, and they had an average participant weighing around 226 to 235 pounds. When comparing the group that didn't take Wegovy to the group that did, the Wegovy group showed an average 35 weight loss at the end of a 2-year study, compared to a 6-pound weight loss in the group, also known the placebo group, of the adults that were just on a reduced caloric diet and an exercise regimen alone. And that sounds substantial, right? Well, Zepbound's study showed that up to 48 pounds of weight loss was achieved on the max dosing, compared to 7 pounds for placebo over the course of 17 months. And we don't have a head-to-head comparison study yet of Wegovy versus Zepbound, but from these trials, we can see that Zepbound is leading the way in the weight loss race by approximately 13 pounds. Wegovy, also known as semaglutide, also known as Ozempic, has been shown to have cardiovascular protection in folks with a history of heart attack or stroke. However, Zepbound, which is tirzepatide, does not have this benefit. Wegovy comes in a prefilled auto-injector that is approximately $405 per dose. And since these medications are dosed once a week, a month's supply would be approximately to $1,600. Zepbound, on the other hand, has options. It originally hit the market as a prefilled auto-injector as well for roughly $320 a dose, which is approximately $1,300 a month. However, in an attempt to make more people buy the medication, to make the medication more affordable, they recently announced that patients can get Zepbound for 40% of the original price if they want to drop their own dosing from a vial, like the good old days when insulin first came on board, bringing that monthly cost down to $480. Still expensive, but not as expensive. While I'm here, I feel the need to share a warning not many people are talking about. If you or if you know of a sexually active woman of childbearing age who's on oral contraception and they're considering Zepbound or Mounjaro, I need you to listen closely. Come on. If you are not planning on reproducing the earth anytime soon, you may want to double up on your contraception in the initial weeks of starting Zepbound or Mounjaro. The reason being is the active ingredient tirzepatide has a special warning recommending patients who are using oral hormonal contraceptives that they should switch to either a non-oral contraceptive method or they should add a barrier method of contraception for 4 weeks after tirzepatide is started and for 4 weeks whenever the dose is increased. As a FYI, I didn't cover all of the side effects and warnings that pertain to this drug class. If you are interested in learning more, I encourage you to check out my other video where I go more into how these drugs work, side effects, warnings, and overall things to consider before starting these medications. And because they're the same active ingredients, information will apply. You can find the link to that video in the description. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this content and want to see more like it, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. I've got plenty of exciting videos planned, and I love for you to be a part of this journey. And I'm also new to YouTube, so your support helps me grow. All right, that's it for me. Stay blessed and stay curious. I'm out.